We are just hours away from the beginning of a new NBA season right here at the TD Garden, where the Boston Celtics will host the Philadelphia 76ers. Now, earlier on, I caught up with Robert Covington, who is the longest-tenured Sixer, and Derek Bodner, who covers the team for The Athletic. I started by asking Robert what it feels like to be back at the arena where the Sixers fell short in the second round of the playoffs back in May.
This is the last arena we've seen, so coming back to start, definitely my best.
Robert, you are the longest tenured Sixer now. Do you feel old?
Nah. I still feel young. Just since my fifth year with Philly, doesn't mean, I feel old. You know, there's a lot of guys in here that, have been in the league longer than I. It's just I've been in the city of Philadelphia the longest, me and Joe. So, it's a blessing to, be here this long, play for the city. So, I'm thankful for it.
Going back to when you were undrafted in 2013, you went to Houston, you've played a lot in the G League as well. What happened between being waived by Houston and joining the Sixers, because now you are an established NBA player?
Just the will to fight, and not giving up, even though that organization didn't believe in me. I never stopped fighting, I never stopped, anything. So I always kept myself just another obstacle in my path. I've been faced with obstacles my entire life. So that wasn't nothing I wasn't used to, and that wasn't nothing I was going to accept. So I was just ready for the next opportunity.
What's the hardest thing about playing in the G League?
Well, I mean, for me, it just was kind of the travel. As far as like being an assignment player, I had more perks than the usual G League guys. I didn't have a roommate. I flew first class. I had perks like similar to flying, being up top, but it's still just that travel of taking 3-4 planes to one city. It's kind of gruesome, so that puts a toll on your body. And then that pretty much is it. And then towards the end of the year, going back and forth for 2.5 weeks straight, based off of playoffs and everything, because we was in the playoffs in down low, and we was in the playoffs in Houston. So I was going back and forth, and basically was on the plane every other day. So that was the toughest part.
What do you think Sam Hinkie saw in you back in the day?
A kid that, has height, that can shoot, very versatile, and, can do a lot of things that didn't compete, That's the main thing, even though, a lot of people said that I couldn't, play against the biggest or the baddest, nobody knew that because they never seen me on the court. And when I did, that's what, matters. So, gave me an opportunity, to come in the organization after that year. So I just took the best of it.
An all-defensive team last season. What have you worked on specifically this summer in that part of your game to get even better?
I worked on a lot. I'm not going to say what all I have worked on, but I just let it show, once we get out there on the court. So.
Sixers ended their season here last year in the second round of the playoffs. What have you sensed from the players at Shootaround this morning about that and opening here?
Yeah, I mean, I think you look at their offseason priorities, a lot of it is geared towards combating what the Celtics did and what they kind of exposed in the playoffs. A lot of it's going to be Joel Embiid, trying to keep him near the paint defensively to better impact the game on that end. A lot of it's going to be Joel Embiid also trying to assert himself. They felt like, he had a mismatch on Al Horford that he didn't really exploit last year. Part of it was he was coming back from that injury. Part of it, he had that mask. But they also think he could be a little more assertive. So I think a lot of it's going to come to Joel Embiid. They want to be able to attack off the dribble a little more. They feel like rookie Landry Shamet can give them a little bit, even though he's inexperienced. They're hoping Markelle Fultz can also give them a little bit off the dribble. So really, those are kind of the three things. Embiid with exploiting his mismatches, keeping Embiid near the rim defensively, and being a little better in beating the Celtics off the dribble.
From the head coach down to the final player on this roster, who's better, Boston or Philadelphia?
Boston's much deeper. They're a deeper team, where the Sixers have to overcome that. A lot of times in this sport, you have one of the best 5 to 10 best players in the league. They can overcome a talent gap, and they need Embiid. He was great last year. He's been great since he entered the NBA. They need him to take that step towards MVP contention. If he can do that, you can cover up a lot of ground, but they need him to be, like I said, he was great. They need him to be even better.
The biggest change so far, at least reading reports that Markelle Fultz and JJ Redick, the rotations, is that biggest change going into this new season?
I mean, I would say just the addition of Markelle Fultz. Last year he obviously played 14 games. This year they're going to count on him to start, and they're going to bring Redick in the starting lineup in the second half. But they're going to rely on Markelle Fultz to insert himself into a lineup that was, Sixers starting lineup last year was probably the best high-minute lineup in the NBA. They're making a pretty major change in putting Markelle Fultz in there, so they're going to need him to play well. They're relying on him. I would say just his presence overall is the biggest change, because he's probably going to get decent minutes starting off, and whether or not he can adapt to the NBA is going to be the big test.
Has Markel Fultz's shot changed from what you've seen?
Yeah, he put a lot of work in over the summer. It certainly seems a little more fluid, a little more. There were all kinds of changes. It's a little more of a one motion shot, a little more out in front of his face. He's certainly worked on it a lot. The question is going to be confidence and consistency, and how far along he got working with Drew Hanlon over the summer, his personal trainer. He looked pretty good in the mid range. He seemed confident and relatively consistent there. The question is going to be now extending that out to 3-point line. There it's been a little inconsistent, and he only really had one game where he attempted, so that's the big question.
Importantly, is Ben Simmons going to attempt a three this year?
Well, he might attempt a three, but it won't be regular. In fact, even in the preseason, he didn't really attempt even like a mid-range shot. He's looked a little bit better from the free throw line. I think that would be a nice boost, because I think a lot of times he was, hesitant to even really draw contact. And if he can be a little more aggressive because he's a little more confident at the line, that'll help. We haven't really seen much in terms of a mid-range jump shot, much less a three-point shot. That's still a work in progress for sure.
Finally, what should the expectations be for this team this year?
Well, certainly, you expect them to challenge. And like I said, I think Boston right now is deeper. I think Boston is better. But they set their expectations of, they set their goal of reaching the NBA Finals. And I think they're going to have to make a lot of progress to get there. But that is their goal. I think their expectation should be, one of the two or three best teams in the Eastern Conference. And if they can improve throughout the season, then they should be able to challenge. But that is their goal, is the NBA Finals.
Thanks for your time, Derek.
Thank you.
So there you have it, Derek Bodner from The Athletic and Robert Covington of the Sixers, who'll be looking to build on his all-defensive first-team selection from last season. So the Sixers and the Celtics, two of the East powerhouses, and no LeBron James in this conference this time around. They'll be heavy favourites to make it to the finals next June, but plenty is set to happen before that point. Max Whittle at the TD Garden in Boston.